Welcome to HUD's online training on the Integrated Disbursement and Information System, also known as IDIS, for the Housing Trust Fund Program. This video will help you get started in IDIS and includes an introduction to the system, a brief demonstration of the basic functions in IDIS, and instructions on how to gain access, log in, and navigate within the system. Come on and let's get started. The Integrated Disbursement and Information System was created as a way for grantees to plan for how they would spend their HUD allocations, collect and report beneficiary data, and allow for the drawdown of funds. IDIS supports HUD CPD-funded formula grant programs, which includes HOME, CDBG, ESG, HOPWA, and HTF. One thing to keep in mind is that IDIS is not an accounting system. Some of the key purposes of IDIS include disbursing funds, collecting accomplishments and performance data, and tracking program compliance. Finally, IDIS also includes planning and grantee reporting modules. While these components are not being covered in this series, more information is available in the resources section of this training page. Let's talk about data. In terms of data collection, the importance of accurate and timely data reporting cannot be overstated. It is important to understand how your Housing Trust Fund data is utilized by HUD. IDIS data is used by both the field office and headquarters to review program compliance. Missing and incorrect data results in an inaccurate and possibly misleading picture of a grantee's Housing Trust Fund program and could lead to potential findings and repayments. Finally, incorrect IDIS data can lead to inaccurate reporting on program accomplishments, which reflects unfavorably on the overall Housing Trust Fund. Let's move on to IDIS functionality. There are many different components within IDIS, so let's start by talking about some of the basic functions. There are four basic functionality areas within IDIS that are relevant to the Housing Trust Fund grantee on the IDIS landing page: plans, projects, and activities, funding drawdown, grants, and reports. First, let's talk about the Plans, Projects, and Activities tab. The Consolidated Plan and the Annual Action Plan can be developed, viewed, and submitted in this tab. HTF grantees are required to submit an HTF allocation plan as part of their Consolidated Plan and Annual Action Plan. After planning has been completed, action plan projects become the framework within which specific IDIS activities are set up. For more information on consolidated plan and annual action plans, view the resources section of this training page. Next, let's discuss activities. Within each action plan project, one or more activities can be set up. Housing Trust Fund activities can be set up, viewed, and edited while in the Plans, Projects, Activities tab. Each Housing Trust Fund activity in the system represents a single Housing Trust Fund project outside of IDIS with its own written agreement. When setting up the activity in IDIS, the system requires an address to be entered upon setup, or at least a legal description of the property. Other required setup fields include basic facts about the activity, such as tenure type, like rental or home buyer, estimated costs, and proposed number of units. Grantees can find all this required information in the HTF written agreement. Grantees should not set up an HTF activity in IDIS until there is an executed written agreement that includes all of this required information. Next is activity funding. Activities are funded in the Funding Drawdown tab. Remember, grantees may only fund an activity in IDIS after executing a written agreement and ensuring that all commitment requirements in 24 CFR 93.2 have been met. This includes securing all the financing for the project and completing the necessary subsidy layering and underwriting. After an activity is funded, the funds can be drawn. Drawdowns can be made while in the Funding Drawdown tab. As eligible costs are incurred and pay requests or invoices are received by the grantee, drawdown vouchers can be created and approved. The last step is project completion. Projects can be completed while in the Plans Projects Activities tab. You should make sure that your HTF project meets the definition of project completion, outlined in 24 CFR 93.2, before completing the activity in IDIS. Remember to enter all beneficiary data and complete the activity in IDIS within 120 days of the final drawdown. There are two additional tabs in IDIS that will be covered in later modules, the Grants tab and the Reports tab. The Grants tab is where HTF grantees can review information about their HTF grants. This is also where subfunds and subgrants can be created and edited. This tab will be covered in a separate module. The Reports tab is where grantees can generate IDIS reports that provide helpful information about your HTF activities, your HTF funds, and your progress toward meeting consolidated and annual action plan goals. IDIS reports can be used to verify and support the data in your annual Consolidated Performance and Evaluation Report, CAPER, as well. The Reports tab will also be covered in a separate module. For more information on CAPERs, view the Resources section of this training page. So now that you have an overview of IDIS, let's move on to gaining access and logging in to IDIS. First, let's talk about new IDIS users versus existing users. Some Housing Trust Fund grantees may be new to IDIS and need access for several staff members. An IDIS online access request form should be filled out for each person requesting access and submitted to the local field office. Links to this form can be found on the IDIS account creation and maintenance page on the HUD Exchange. If a local IDIS administrator needs to be added, complete the form for them first and then add other users. If you are an existing IDIS user, the local IDIS administrator can add Housing Trust Fund access and privileges to your existing profile. Now that you've requested access, let's review the IDIS login page, accessible by typing idis.hud.gov into your browser window, or follow the link on the HUD Exchange IDIS program page. Each user should come prepared with their username and password. Finally, the login page provides the phone number for the HITS National Help Desk, in case you forget your password and need to have it reset. It's recommended that IDIS users maintain their passwords by logging into the system at least every 30 days. This will limit the need for password resets due to being locked out of the system. Please visit the IDIS program page on the HUD Exchange at www.hudexchange.info/programs/IDIS for more information and links to a number of resources and documents to support you in using and accessing IDIS. Congratulations! You've completed the introduction and overview of IDIS and are now ready to move on to one of the additional modules in this series.